Conventional security perspectives tend to focus much attention on the protection of sovereignty and territorial integrity of states from external military threats. In the contemporary world, however, a full understanding of the concept of security requires one to not only examine the threats posed by other states, but also consider the threats emanating from non-state forces. These threats, also known as asymmetric security threats, confront many of our current-day states, and addressing them is a big challenge, as these threats range from hard to the near impossibility of knowing their exact identity, location, and capabilities. One of these threats stand out, however, as being the most challenging, and that is transnational organized crime.
Despite the situation that the government didn't take proper action and nothing in line, I am estimated
$700 million.
Inside this warehouse of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in Los Angeles is a random sample of endangered or protected species of wildlife from around the world, discovered, stuffed, and mounted in the homes of private collectors in the United States. More parts of it were from the foot of an African elephant, chopped off and made into a fish. This Asian tiger made its fate on a ranch in Colorado.
Colorado had a cage, and an influential hunter paid $20,000 to walk up to the cage and shoot it. What we call a gaslight.
Agents say smuggled into the U.S. every day are elephant tusks for ivory jewelry.
What exactly are transnational organized crimes? Let's go back to mid-1970s, where the concept of transnational crime was used by the United Nations in order to identify certain criminal activities which transcend national jurisdictions. Its crimes included, among others, money laundering, terrorist activities, theft of art and intellectual property, weapons, drugs, and human trafficking, selling of human body parts, fraudulent bankruptcy, and corruption and bribery of public or party officials. Since then, transnational crime has spread exponentially, and its viewpoints changed in many major ways. For example, drug trafficking has become more diversified. Criminal networks has given birth to new methods of conducting business, and the structure of criminal networks has changed entirely. Organized crime also has gone global, giving way to the term transnational organized crime. Global governance has failed to keep pace with this revolution, and its effects are massive. Although unprecedented openness in trade, finance, travel, and communication has created economic growth and well-being, it has also given rise to massive opportunities for criminals to make their business prosper. Transnational organized crimes can undermine democracy, disrupt free markets, drain national assets, and inhibit the development of stable societies. It is then understood that there is a lack of information on transnational criminal markets and trends. The few studies that exist have looked at sections of the problem, by sector or country, rather than the big picture. Without a global perspective, there cannot be an evidence-based policy. And, by the mid-1990s, the relatively orderly Cold War system had given way to a world of greater uncertainty and an ever-growing number of perceived threats to nation-states. These new developments, coupled with immense technological changes in recent years, have heightened our concern over nation-states' vulnerability to cross-border criminal activity. It is a global concern that forces of globalization that facilitate economic growth and positive cultural and social change are also inadvertently being utilized for negative effects and are benefiting perpetrators of crime across boundaries of nations and continents. Transnational crime is taking advantage of the globalization process to enhance the speed and frequency of its conduct of illicit activities. Surprisingly, these criminals are quick to adapt to the changes of technology, people, and goods mobility
to cross borders through social networks while exploiting the lack of international cooperation between countries. They also exploit different legal frameworks between countries to successively undermine state efforts in curbing their illicit activities. Burdened by bureaucracy, bounds of sovereignty, and an uncoordinated international system, law enforcement bodies and agencies around the world are ineffective in their endeavor to catch up with the flow and the dynamism employed by criminal organizations. Transnational networks have been utilized by criminal organizations to increase the speed and frequency of their operations and to increase the degree of challenge to the authority of the state with an enhanced capacity to plan, direct, and organize their criminal operations in countries while based in another.